Greetings and welcome to another video. So last class we have discussed about the condensers. Today we'll start with the types of condenser. There are two types of condenser. One is Z condenser and the surface condenser. Let us compare the Z condenser and the surface condenser. In Z condenser, steam and water comes in direct contact. In surface condenser, no direct contact takes place. Condensation is due to mixing of the coolant and the steam. And in this case, the condensation is due to heat transfer by conduction and convection, where a surface is there in between the steam and the coolant. In Z condenser, the condensate mixes with the coolant or cooling water, so it is not fit for use as a boiler feed water if the cooling water is not demineralized water. In surface condenser, the condensate is fit or it can be reused as boiler feed water. The cost of Z condenser is less, and it does not affect the plant efficiency. But in case of a surface condenser, it is costly and it helps improve the plant efficiency. Maintenance cost is low in Z condenser and high in surface condenser. Now we will discuss in details about Z condenser first. So in Z condenser, two fluids mix up and exchange heats between them. Let us understand it like this. Say this is the condenser cell in which the mixing takes place. So in this condenser cell, both steam and the cooling water should enter into the cell. Suppose this is the exhaust steam. From the turbine and entering into the condenser cell. This is the cooling water or coolant entering into the condenser cell. And the condensate will be deposited here and accordingly it will be extracted from for any use. If cooling water is not fit for the feed water, then this condensate cannot be used as a feed water. Classification of Z condensers. Z condensers are classified like this. One is low level Z condenser, and this low level Z condenser is again classified as counter flow low level Z condenser and parallel flow low level Z condenser. In this case, the counter flow means the steam flows in one direction and the cooling water flows in opposite direction. That is why it is called counter flow. And in case of a parallel flow, both steam and the cooling water flows in the same direction. That is why it is called parallel flow Z condenser. That means low level Z condenser. Next is high level Z condenser. This we will discuss in details. There is another condenser, that is the ejector Z condenser. So we will discuss one by one in details. First we will discuss counter flow low level Z condenser. This is the counter flow Z condenser. This one is the cell. That means condenser cell, in which cooling water will enter like this. Cooling water. This condenser should have vacuum pressure. So this one is the air extraction pump. This will extract the air to the atmosphere, and this pressure will be vacuum pressure. Exhaust steam will enter from the bottom and it will move like this. These are the perforated trays. Through the perforated trays, the steam will move up and the water, cooling water, will come down through these perforated trays. So during this process, the intense mixing of cooling water and the exhaust steam takes place, and steam is condensed and the cooling water become hot. So this water along with the condensate will be collected below, and this condensate, that means mixture of condensate and the cooling water, will be extracted by this pump. This pump is called the condensate extraction pump, and the condensate will be collected in the hot well. This is hot well. The feed water, if it is used in the boiler, will be pumped to the boiler as a feed water. The excess water from the hot well will come to the cooling pond. So this is a large pond in which the evaporation from the pond takes place, and this water become cold. This cold water will be entering into the condenser cell, and there is no need of pump. Pump is not required because the pressure inside the condenser cell is vacuum pressure, and this, due to this pressure difference, this is the atmospheric pressure, one atmospheric pressure. So this is high pressure compared to this vacuum pressure. So due to the pressure difference, the water will automatically go to the condenser cell. Now the question is, why it is called counter flow? As we have seen that the exhaust steam is moving up and the water is coming down. So one is moving up, one is coming down. That is why it is called counter flow jet condenser. The low level jet condenser, because the height of this is below 5.5 meter. So in case of a low level jet condenser, this height up to which the water has to move up to enter into the condenser cell is 5.5 meter or less. That is why it is called low level. It is having disadvantage of flooding the steam turbine if the condensate extraction pump fails. So due to some reason, if this extraction pump does not work, then the water deposited inside the condenser cell will be flooded and it will go to the turbine. That means it will enter into the turbine. So that is one disadvantage. In case of a pump failure, the condensate will cause flooding of the turbine. That means due to the backflow, overflow, it will go to the turbine. So this is about counter flow jet condenser. Parallel flow jet condenser. All the principles are same as counter flow. Only difference is flow direction, better to say flow direction is different. You can see this is the direction of steam flow, exhaust steam, and this is the direction of cooling water. We can see that both cooling water and steam are coming down. So that is why it is called parallel flow jet condenser. And when both steam and cooling water is coming down, both steam and cooling water mixes and the steam is condensed and the cooling water become hot. So these are the condensate, and the condensate will be extracted by the pump, and this is the condensate extraction pump. Next, we'll discuss the high level jet condenser. To understand high level jet condenser, it is important to understand the barometric height of a column of a fluid. We all know that height of a mercury column for atmospheric pressure is 760 millimeter of mercury. And that means 760 millimeter of mercury is equal to 1 atmospheric pressure. That means 1 atmospheric pressure can hold 760 millimeter of mercury in a column. In place of mercury, if we use water as the fluid, then the height of this water column is equal to approximately 10.32 meter. That means 1 atmospheric pressure can hold 10.32 meter of water column. So with this understanding, we'll try to understand the high level jet condenser. This is a high level jet condenser. So let's start with air extraction pump. Air is extracted by this pump and this vacuum is created inside the condenser cell. Cooling water is pumped by this circulating pump, and the path for the cooling water is like this. Because of the baffles over here, these baffles are some obstruction in the flow of cooling water while it is coming down. So it will come down in a zigzag path. At the same time, the exhaust steam will enter from this side. So the exhaust steam will try to go up, and the same path is also for the exhaust steam, and it will try to go up. So while coming up and water going down, this cooling water and the exhaust steam will mix intensely, and the exhaust steam will give heat to the cooling water, and cooling water will absorb the heat. As a result, the steam will become water. So both the mixture of cooling water and the condensate will settle down over here, and it will be collected in the hot well. This is the circulating pump. In case of a low level jet condenser, this circulating pump is not required because this height is very less, 5.5 meter or less. So without any circulating pump, because of the pressure difference, this cooling water can go up to the condenser cell, which is in vacuum pressure. Now the condensate will be collected here. And this height, this is the important point, is more than 10.32 meter of barometric head. That means if this height is more than 10.32 meter of meter, then this column cannot hold water above this. So if the water level rises, then water will be collected to the hot well, because this water column cannot hold more than 10.32 meter of water column. So there is no need of any extraction pump. Condensate extraction pump is not required because of this height of this tailpipe. This is called a tailpipe. So height of the tailpipe is more than 10.32 meter. So above that height, all water will come down and will be collected in the hot well. So from hot well, the overflowed water will go to the cooling pump, where it will be cold because of the large surface area, and the cold water will be pumped through the circulating pump and the process is repeated. The main points in this case is that there is no extraction pump. That means condensate extraction pump, because of the height of the tailpipe, which is more than 10.32 meter. So if this height become more than 10.32, this excess water will automatically come down and it will be collected in the hot well, and air extraction pump will definitely be there, and there will be some vacuum pressure inside this. And in this case also the flow is counter flow, because the water is coming down and exhaust steam is going up. There is another jet condenser that is called the ejector jet condenser. So this is the exhaust steam entering into the condenser non-return valve, and the exhaust steam will enter like this, and these nozzles are, some are convergent nozzle and some are convergent divergent nozzle. Because of the nozzle effect, the pressure energy is converted to kinetic energy. The steam will get some kinetic energy over here, and cooling water is coming down, and these are like the spray of steam. So the spray of steam and the cooling water coming down, they will mix. So this is a parallel flow. In a nozzle, the pressure energy is converted to kinetic energy. So due to this kinetic energy or velocity of the steam, there will be some spray of steam in this stream, and water is coming down because of the gravity itself, good mixing of the water and the steam, and in that process the steam is converted to water, that means condensation, and water become hot. In this case, one pump is used which is condensate, coolant and air to hot well. That means the pump used is wet pump. That means it will pump both air as well as the condensate, and it will go to the hot well. The advantages and disadvantages of jet condenser. There are some advantages. Less quantity of cooling water is required to condense the steam, because this is a direct mixing, so less quantity of water can convert the steam to the water. The construction is simple and cost is low. Does not require cooling water pump. In some cases, cooling water pump is not required, but cooling circulating pump is required. So less space is required. Within a very small space, this type of jet condenser can be operated. But in case of a surface condenser, large area is required for construction of this condenser and cooling arrangement. Low maintenance cost. These are some advantages. But the disadvantage is that the condensate is a waste. That means since the steam become condensate, and this condensate is mixed with the cooling water. Now, if this cooling water quality is not good, because the good condensate and bad cooling water mixes, so it cannot be used as feed water again. And this is less suitable for high capacity plants. This is not for high capacity, for small plant the jet condensers can be used. Large length of pipes required, hence piping cost is high. There are many pipes are used in jet condenser, accordingly the piping cost will be higher. Now we'll discuss the surface condenser. The word surface means between the steam and the cooling water, there will be one surface. And generally, these are separated by one pipe. The cooling water will be inside the tubes, and outside the tubes, there will be steam. There are two types of surface condenser. One is purely surface condenser, and other is called the evaporative condenser. In surface condenser, steam flows outside the network of tubes and water flows inside the tubes. In evaporative condenser, there is no condenser cell. The steam passes through condenser tubes. So this is opposite. The water is sprayed while the air passes upwards. That means in this case, the content of the tube is steam, and there will be spray of water over these tubes. So we'll discuss in details how both surface condenser and evaporative condenser works. Surface condensers. Surface condensers are classified as purely surface condenser and evaporative condenser. In surface condenser, the steam flows outside the network of tubes and water flows inside the tubes like this. The blue one is the tube, and this tube is surrounded by the steam. Then in evaporative condensers, there is no condenser cell. The steam passes through condenser tubes. The water is sprayed while the air passes upward outside the tube. This tube contains steam, and water is sprayed over these tubes in evaporative condenser. This sprayed water, some of them get evaporated by absorbing the latent heat of evaporation and keep the surface of the tube cool, and that makes the heat transfer possible, or continued heat transfer is possible. Again, surface condensers are classified as single pass and multi-pass surface condenser based on number of water passes. The water passes in a single time, so this is called single pass. And in case of a multi-pass, for example double pass, the water passes once and again. This is second pass, and this is first pass. So in this case, it will be called double pass surface condenser based on the number of water passes. If the number of passes 3, then it will be called triple pass surface condenser. So more than one pass is called multi-pass surface condensers. Surface condenser again can be classified like downflow and central flow surface condenser depending on the direction of condensate flow. Which way the condensate flow, based on that it is called downflow or central flow. In this example, the steam is entering from the top and condensate is going out from the bottom. This is the air extraction pump. It is situated towards the bottom, therefore the steam will tend to go towards the bottom, and during that process steam will get condensed and become water. Flow of the condensate it towards the bottom, and that is why it is called downflow. In this example, this is the air pump situated at the center of the condenser cell. Steam will enter from the top, and the steam will tend to flow towards the center because the air extraction pump is situated at the center, and therefore the condensate flow direction is towards the center of the cell, and it is called central flow surface condenser, and condensate will be collected from the bottom. So let us discuss surface condenser in details. These blue ones are the water tubes through which the cooling water passes. Suppose the cooling water passes from right to the left. So these tubes will be surrounded by the steam. This is the front view. This is the front view of the condenser cell, and this is the side view of the condenser cell. These blue ones are the water tubes through which the cooling water passes. Now these tubes will be covered by some plates, and both the ends, left and the right of the condenser cell, will be closed by two cover plates. This one is the box, water box, and this is also water box. Water enters the water box at the right side, and it will pass through the water tubes and enter into the water box at the left, and ultimately it will go out of the cell. So these are the water tubes. Water will enter through this, it will enter into the water box, then passes through the water tubes, enter into the water box at the left, and it will go out of the cell. Steam will enter from the top. Steam enter, and steam will passes through this, and during this the steam will get condensed, and condensate will be collected at the bottom. Condensate will be collected by the condensate extraction pump. So exhaust steam coming from the top, condensate extracted from the bottom. These are the water tubes through which the cooling water passes from the right side to the left side. Cooling water in from right and cooling water going out from the left. These are the water box. So first cooling water enter inside the water box at the right, passes through the water tubes, enter into the water box at the left, and go out of the condenser from the water box. The previous one was single pass condenser, and this one is double pass surface condenser. As you can see, the cooling water entered into the water box, then it will passes through the water tubes, again enter into the water box. From this water box, the cooling water passes through the water tubes again and enters the water box and goes out of the condenser cell. So this first part is the first pass, and second one is the this is the second pass. This is the first pass. So there are two passes. So that is why it is called double pass surface condenser. All other things are same like single pass. This is the cover plate. The whole thing is a cylindrical cell condenser. Steam enters from the top, condensate collected at the bottom, and one wet air pump collects the condensate as well as air. This is cross-sectional view of condenser cell for downflow surface condenser. Steam enters from the top, condensate collected at the bottom, and the air extraction pump is situated towards the bottom of the cell. The steam entering into the cell tends to go towards the bottom because the air extraction pump creating the vacuum is situated towards the bottom. Due to the placement of these baffles, the steam or condensate cannot go to the air extraction pump, and due to the gravity, the condensate will be collected at the bottom. And because of the flow of the condensate and steam towards the bottom, this one is called the downflow surface condenser. That means condensate is flowing down because the air extraction pump is situated towards the bottom of the cell. This is central flow surface condenser. The air extraction pump is situated at the center of the boiler cell. So definitely the air extraction pump is creating the vacuum at the center, and therefore the steam tends to flow towards the center of the boiler cell. Condensate flow direction is towards the center, and that is why it is called central flow surface condenser. Now let us discuss about evaporative condenser. The principle of evaporation is used in evaporative condenser. The principle is that the water is sprayed over the tubes containing the steam. The water touching the tube surface will receive the heat from the steam. Some water will be evaporated by absorbing the latent heat of evaporation. The exhaust steam is passed through the series of gill tubes called condenser coil. This is the condenser coil with some gills, and gills helps increase the surface area of the tubes, and therefore the rate of heat transfer increases. Thin film of cooling water trickles over these tubes continuously from water nozzles. So water is sprayed from the water nozzle from the top. During the condensation of steam, this thin film of water is evaporated and the remainder water is collected in the tank. Some of this water sticking to these tubes will get evaporated and go escape from the condenser, and the rest water will be collected at the water tank below. The condensate is extracted with the help of wet air pump. This one is wet air pump, which extract the condensate, enter as steam and exit as liquid. The air passing over the tubes carries the evaporated water in the form of vapor, and it is removed with the help of induced draft fan installed at the top. This one is induced draft fan, and it will take the air towards the upward direction. So there is the flow direction of the air is towards upwards, and water is sprayed from the top. So this is exhaust steam entering through the tubes. Condensate, the steam coming out as condensate or in the form of liquid. These are the condenser coil or gill tubes. These tubes are fixed with some gill that increases the surface area for fast heat transfer. More surface area increases the heat transfer rate. These are the water nozzles. Cooling water from the water tank it is used, and some of the cooling water get evaporated and lost to the atmosphere, and the rest is again collected to the water tank. So merits and demerits of surface condenser. In surface condenser, no mixing of cooling water and steam, and therefore the condensate directly pumped into the boiler. The condensate can be directly used as boiler feed water. Any kind of cooling water can be used in surface condenser because the cooling water is not mixed with the steam. Cooling water can be again used and it is completely separate from the condensate. Surface condenser develops high vacuum, therefore it is very suitable for large power plant, and it gives more work output, and the efficiency of the plant increases because of the high vacuum or low pressure. Surface condenser requires less power to run the air pump and water pump. System is very efficient, but there are some disadvantages. It requires large quantity of cooling water. So in places where large quantities of cooling water are not available throughout the year, surface condenser cannot be used. System is complicated, costly, and high maintenance cost. It requires large floor space and it is very bulky. Otherwise, the surface condenser is best for large power plant, and the condensate can be again used as boiler feed water. So, thank you.